Hi there, my name is Ron Rogers, and I had a request from one of my longtime followers for a little video of me and my son flying together. Now, we're both airline pilots. Well, I'm retired. I'm a retired 777 captain. That was my last airplane, and my son is currently on the 777, also for United, out in San Francisco. And he gets back to the cold Midwest here once in a while, and we go flying together in either my Turbo 310R or the Great Lakes. And I taught my son to fly, and I cut short the taxiway there, but I taught my son to fly. And the only aerobatics we've done until about now, and he's got about 18,000 hours now, we're doing spins when I was checking him out. But we're going to take off here in the Great Lakes, and we're going to go out west to do some aerobatics. Now, it was a little bit of a crosswind that day and breezy, so you can probably notice on the rudder there some pretty good rudder usage to keep the airplane going straight. But this airplane handles very well in a crosswind. Get the power in, get the tail up, and away we go off of the Lake in the Hills runway there, 3 Charlie Kilo. There you can see the somewhat aggressive rudder use, which you need in a tail dragger aircraft. Get it airborne there. And get some smash up, the old fighter pilot term, get some speed up here as we're accelerating. And then I like to do a nice climbing turn. Some people might think call that a chandelle, but it's not, because you're just above stall speed at the end of a chandelle, and I certainly don't do that low altitude in the pattern. But here we are making the nice climbing turn. And the fun thing about this, with a 180 horsepower engine, you get about a 3,000 foot per minute initial rate of climb there, which is nice and impressive. So we're going to head on out here west, and we're going to do some aerobatics. Now, I've already taken my son up on one flight, so he's going to go up, and we're going to fly again. So he's done these maneuvers the first time, and he's developing a little bit of skill. But for a brand new airline pilot, I think he does fairly well. So the first thing we're doing is a loop. We get our 130 knots, a nice straight pull back on the stick, 3G input here. Start to float a little bit over the top, throw your head back, pick up the line, the section line you lined up on there. Now we got a little slow, so you notice how it kind of pinched there a little bit. But we're getting the airspeed back up for the entry. If you do it right, you'll be right back at entry airspeed, and you can pull right up into another one. So we pull up into another one here, floated a little more over the top. Yep, that's a little better there, and come on back around. Now, if you let the airspeed increase there, you can get 135 knots for the entry into a hammerhead. And I really enjoy hammerheads. They're to me one of the most fun maneuver. And this airplane has such good control power. When I had my aerobatic school and I taught in the Citabran Decathlon, you had to really manhandle the controls. This aircraft just has so much power. So a nice 3G pull up to the vertical line. You check that? Okay. Just as you run out of airspeed, rudder, opposite aileron. You can see it in there to keep it from going over on its back. Nice vertical line. For a second, pull it back out. Get your entry airspeed, and you can go right back up into a second one. Get the vertical line, running out of airspeed. Bring the rudder in, opposite aileron again. Bring it on over, nice down line, and then pull it on out. Now the next thing we did was snap rolls. Those are just a horizontal spin, and the Citabran Decathlon came out immediately of the snap. Now the Great Lakes, a little bit slower, it's a little harder to plan, takes some finesse, and there we went kind of past and dished out on the nose. So yeah, we'll try that again. That's the nice thing about it, you can do a lot of these in quick succession. So we'll pull up here on another one. Do a quick snap here, stick back, rudder in. Whoop, came out too early, so we're doing essentially a snap to a split S there. No problem, we enter those at about 65 miles per hour, so we're slow airspeed, so you can easily do that. So let's try one more here, see if we can get this thing down. And stick full back, rudder in, bring it on around, wait till you just about come out. Ah, there you go, not too bad at all. Alrighty, well, let's go ahead and get some patterns up at Dacey Airport. Now we're coming in on 3-6, and it's kind of dry, and the ground's kind of rough. We're coming across the there. Now watch the tail wheel. This is something on a sod runway. You can get a little disturbance there. And Lou, do you see that? It went 90 degrees to the left there. I'm glad that wasn't pavement, or I could have blown the tire. But on pavement, you probably wouldn't have gotten that little hit. So anyway. You know, grass fields are wonderful, but when they get dry and the surface isn't the most smooth, you get a little bit more of a rough ride. So that's a quick little fun time flying with my son. I hope you enjoyed it and found it interesting. And stay tuned. We'll have a few more videos once I get my airplane out of its annual and back flying again. I hope you enjoyed this short video. Thanks for watching.